Well, today it's time for an album which is called Love Is Dead by Kelly. Is that right? Did I spell that correctly? Because Kelly is a singer-songwriter from Estonia, a country I've never did so far in my reviews. And I mean, yeah, mostly it's like in English countries or from English countries and so on. Well, that's pretty interesting, but as we see on the lyrics right here, the left side of the first track, it's probably going to be all over in English. So yeah, it's a debut studio album by Estonia singer-songwriter Kelly, which was released 2008. So it's a 2000s. So that's pretty interesting, because I looked at this cover, the 2010s, huh? Well, not the 2000s, the 2000s. Because I looked at this cover and I was like, kind of, what is this? So I was kind of curious, what to go into this album right here. But yeah, I don't know why, but it looks like a kind of like a doll holding this little goat or something there. And then, like, there is like these, this kind of like 2000s emo kind of writing, typing thing. I don't know. And there are like blue flowers, and it's like so blue all over it, and it's so emo kind of. And I mean, the 2000s here and there, maybe also the 90s back then, were kind of like that. But yeah, I'm kind of like curious how this album will sound right here. Well, the cover gives me kind of like a feeling this is going to be a ride. But yeah, the album marks the first and only release on both labels from Universal Music Group and Island Records. So UMG was on this one right here, so there must be something, right? And yeah, there was a lead single, something kind of, and there was also a final single, Walking Away and Love Is Dead. But let's see what this album sounds like. Cover looks interesting. Never heard of this artist, and also I don't know if it's probably all over the world or just in Estonia or something. I'm not sure, but so yeah, let's just jump right into it. The first track is called Love Is Dead. We got 12 tracks, if I remember that correctly. Yeah, that's true. So let's just jump right into it, right? Let's go. This kind of like reminds me really of the 2000s kind of like emo pop rock, if I remember like correctly, like bands like Evanescence, is that right? I know, I only know like some songs in that one really popular, I don't know how this one's called again, like Wake Me Up Inside, you know what I mean? It was a meme, it was really, it's really popular. Kind of like reminds me of that. To be honest, I never really listened to this album, not this album, this kind of like genre or the sound. So that's pretty interesting, going to like this the first time all over any music experience I had. And there's some interesting instruments going into this one. I haven't seen those strings coming. They were pretty nice. I don't know if they're like, I guess they're pretty well kind of recorded, I guess. I don't know if they're just like some, like, well, here it is, like the 2000s were the production styles, with the music kind of like changing, was made more cheap, like especially like the pop music back then in the 2000s, I guess, was made with just like the least effort mostly, while of course there were like groups that didn't do that, especially like live groups and stuff like that. But going into this one right here, going into pop rock, it also was pretty like typical to throw some guitars in there, and mostly they're pre-recorded. I don't think we got it right here. The strings sounds pretty nice, and the overall singing is a little bit weird for me right now. Maybe I'm going to get into that with a little bit more listening, but yeah, you know what I mean. Let's move on. So yeah, that was the first track, Love Is Dead. I like the arrangements, and I mean, this track is like very full. They use every second to get something new in there. It's pretty like this heavy wall of sound. You got the really heavy kind of like drummings. You got the constant strings that got added into this one right here. And also the vocals get some different styles here and there. This like typical little bit like hushy lo-fi thing is there. Then sometimes the singing is not on point for me personally or up my kind of like taste, but still I think that this track got a lot of quality, especially in the production style. But yeah, on the first track, Love Is Dead, I'm feeling a 7, so pretty nice. When I was listening to kind of like the lyrics and stuff and living through it, I mean, it's most like the same. Love Is Dead, Love Is Gone. So yeah, let's move on with the next track. Was the second track, which is called Walking on Air.
There's a little creepy house in a little creepy place, a little creepy town in a little creepy world. Girls, know that you could set your world strong enough to leave your doubts. Feel it, breathe it, believe it, and you'll be walking on air. Move on, and you're forgiven. I knew that, I could feel that. I feel like I am walking on air. Yeah, with her little funny old blue hat on fire. Never thought she could do that. Feel it, breathe it.
This is a nice track. I love both strings on this one. These two parts on this track are really like diverse, and it gets a lot of like change ups right here into this one. And it's a nice chorus. It's nice singing, nice backing instrumentation. Those really like noise drums are really nice, and also really diverse. Just songwriting on this one. Like about like this creepiness of this little things she just explains all over it. Feel it and breathe it, and you'll be walking on air. And then there comes in these strings and like fly so high, if you know what I mean. It really suits instrumentation on this track, which I like. So yeah, nice track. This was a nice track. Also those like boxed up and really like little strings that you can hear in the back, pretty like fussy played. I think those were strings were also a nice addition to some like detailed instrumentation, and I really liked it. So yeah, this one is a really good track. I like this one. I give that one somewhere between an 8 and a 9. So let's move on with the next track, which is called The Creationist, the third track. This track, this cover is a little bit like disorienting, because if I listen to this track, I think about like really nice summery days and it's beautiful outside and you love just life. And then she thinks about like life is my creation, keep going on, is my best friend, imagination is my defense, and I keep walking, the skies are gray. Is then something I guess like, huh, okay. So kind of like she still stays in the same kind of like box she's in right now and when thinking about the songwriting. But yeah, really nice little piano on this track right here. But let's see, I think it's building up to something. Let's see how this track will evolve. Let's go. So yeah, nice little track right here. I wish that there would be a little bit more something like even more detailed. Like the also production, like besides the last chorus right there, is very detailed and gets like some really nice instrumentation. The piano is really nice, the piano riff right there, and also other different like details are really nice. The chorus right at the end is just like bam, here you got some compression. But I mean, yeah, it works. And for that, I think it's still a great track. So I give that one something between a 7 and an 8. So yeah, to the next track, which is called I Want Nothing. Let's go. This is a really straightforward track. It goes straight into the more like the full side of this album, into like all the instrumentations coming in, like fast drumming. This is the fastest track I guess so far, and I mean, I enjoy the chorus right here. The song is also really interesting. But I want nothing. If you think that you got it, why you're treating me like a whore, and I want nothing, faking it all the time, conscious it cuts like a knife, and so on. I like the songwriting on this one. This is pretty direct, kind of like the side of songwriting they always like did when coming into, yes, like everyone around me treats me not right, and so on. And I mean, it kind of is enjoyable throughout this track, listening and going through this right here, and watching like other people's having the time of your lives, happy within your disguise, and so on. But yeah, the song is pretty nice. So yeah, let's move on. Yeah, I mean, it's a very fast and sonic track and really goes straight into the songwriting, which is pretty nice. I like the fast kind of like instrumentation on this one. It's really has a very strong feeling to it and really gets you into a certain feeling right here of like power and like a little bit of anger maybe also. Like she really gets you into kind of like a feeling of like this strong vibe she wants to get across, and I like it for that. But overall, I think there needs to be a little bit of a, like a pause or like a gap between to get a little bit of a breather. Well, this is a very sonic track for that. So we don't really have anything really like that on this track, which makes it a little bit not as much as I wanted it to be. But yeah, I can see why this one is like a kind of like a straight banger if you listen to this one. But I'm feeling on this one like a 6. So let's move on with the fifth track, which is called Up, Up, Up. It's going more in the pop direction, I guess. Well, there are some like really like punched drums right here, and the kick is like really like heavy and full. There are some parts left in the kind of like the rock side, but we I'm sorry but we got a kind of like a acoustic guitar on this one right here, and my keyboard unplugged. Wait a minute. There we go. So yeah, I kind of like was going into this one with some like other expectations, especially after the first track. But the singing is kind of like more suitable for this kind of style of the maybe instrumentations, if you know what I mean. Her voice really suits this track right here, I guess, but maybe just because not really familiar with the sound of the first track, and I was like kind of like thinking right here when listening to this one, oh yeah, I know this. If you know what I mean, maybe I got that. The lyrics mostly really are a little bit repetitive, but I guess the sound is something really to look at right here, and the kind of like the style she's singing. She got this really nice voice. It's a little bit, has different ways of singing, which is really amazing. I don't know if there are like more many vocalists on this album. That could also be because it's just like so diverse. But I guess it's the same person on this album right here. But also going into like maybe the instrumentations, I guess there are some like different approaches on this one into different pop directions that were not really there in the 2000s even. I don't really know in which kind of like space I should put this right here into. But yeah, it's an interesting track. Let's move on. Well, I know this kind of like sound, it's like this kind of like this typical pop, something maybe rock side, going to also some different sides, maybe some artsy pop, going to like these strings that I also got added right at the end. And the repetitive lyrics gave me kind of like a feeling this is something more easy listening you get in like in the kind of 2000s radio maybe or something. And for that, it's an enjoyable listen, but it's not like really getting me into like something really to digest right here. It's easy, kind of like nice food, if you know what I mean, through the nice production style on this one. Well, yeah, I like it. Still, I don't think it's like something really heavy or something, but yeah, I give this one a 7 also. So yeah, let's move on with the next track, which is called Bulletproof, the 6th track. Stop hiding. interesting songwriting, and to that one, like being bulletproof is something I can't really digest right now, and what she really means, that was a song that makes me like fly, but where are you tonight, something isn't right, can you please stop hiding, and so on, I can't fake it anymore, and so on, because I'm not bulletproof. So maybe she's like telling, well, all these things happen, did you know that I can be hurt or something, do you even care or something, maybe even something like that. Pretty typical emo songwriting, if you know what I mean. The instrumentation is straightforward into some pop rock, and some more noisier sides of that. And for that, I think it's pretty predictable, if you know what I mean, in the sound. While I didn't really listen to many of these tracks, I still think, well, I can already tell that many of these tracks sounds like that, but I still enjoy the songwriting, and it's a bop. So yeah, nice. Let's move on. A little bit of a nice ending right there. I like the instrumentation going into a transition into the last bit, ultra right here we have, and also how it ends with a nice feedback still going on, and then she gets a little bit of this like whispery voice at the end right there. Was a nice way to leave this track at the end. So yeah, it was a nice one. Still giving this one 7. So let's move on with the 7th track, which is called Beautiful Day. This track right here goes in a completely different direction, into straight some 2000s pop. Maybe something also in the beginning of the 2010s were pretty present, going into maybe some stuff like Carly Rae Jepsen did, maybe. Like those strings right here are really nice, nicely sampled, I guess. It sounds like a sample. And they also had these little nice stops at the beginning as an intro, and was a nice instrumentation right here. Now they're like lo-fi in the back as a texture, while we have these claps right here that are a little bit, yeah, I mean, sure. But I like the instrumentation. Let's see where else this gets. Also, the song is nice. Someone is born and someone dies. Someone is holding the light. I'm standing in the light now, and so on. Let's see. Because it's more of an optimistic track right here. I mean, I wish it would be a little bit more of these like strings oriented nice sound right here, and because I really enjoyed those, they weren't really like coming back anymore that like much, maybe just at the end right there, but also like those acoustic guitars pretty nicely. But besides that, there's not much instrumentation to get into, and it's a little bit skeletal for that, but I still really enjoyed those strings, they were amazing. And I mean, her singing is all right on this one also. So yeah, I give that one between a 6 and a 7. So yeah, let's move on with the next track, which is called Creepshow, the 8th track. Finish. I know where it's at. Maybe it's because I live in Europe. But it's a left upper corner besides Russia, right? So yeah, I know where it is. Let's move on. So yeah, this track right here really was a creep show kind of, if you know what I mean. First, this track was a little bit repetitive, going into the songwriting right here. Nobody knows where it's at. But yeah, I mean, it builds up the instrumentation right here, so you get a kind of like a feeling that it wants to do. I like the way she really gets this, like when she sings like "Welcome to the" and then "Creepshow," how she sings that with this really nice stereorized and mixed vocals right there, and then goes also into "Cinnamon Houses and Licorice Ties," and then it moves on with that, and then it goes into some real Estonia singing. I don't know. I've never heard, really heard that language, but it really sounds interesting. And then really we have these like weird how do you call it, this lullaby music going on in the back and instrumentation. And then she sings that like really whispery, or like tells that stuff right there. I don't know what it means. Like a reindeer has a little house in the forest, so on, and knock, open up. There's an evil hunter in the forest and so on, a little bit like a fairy tale or something. And I mean, it sounds interesting. And also going into just like the songwriting, maybe in this whole sound of this track, and it was kind of like, it was an enjoyable track, but not something really that blew me away instrumentally. But it was a fun track, so yeah, I give that one a 6. So let's move on with the next track, the ninth track, which is called "Hurt Me." I like the part where it like gets into this track with this really nice beat. The tops are really nice on those drums, and kind of like the filter she got on her voice really suits her on this track, and it gets like some really abrasive like also like chorus. What I think that the chorus is alright. It doesn't like blow me away like the first, like the instrumentation overall, because it's like a little bit too full, like too much instrumentation, too much noise a little bit there, and in my opinion it doesn't really suit this track, and too much compression. Well, it could use a little bit less and more, like her vocal range could be more in the center, and it would make it a little bit more direct, if you know what I mean with that. Because it's like a little bit overwhelming with all those overblowing stuff getting right at you. I mean, it kind of makes sense going into like if you want to do some abrasive stuff, yeah. Just my personal feeling, as always. Lol. But yeah. Yeah, let's move on. This track kind of reminded me of an album I reviewed a little bit of a long time ago, by Willow. I can't remember how it's called right now, but it goes always a little bit into this direction. Like this track goes right here. It's not like this really almost alternative metal rock pop side, if you know what I mean, what Evanescence really does in the emo side. This one stays in the emo side, but still goes into maybe some other directions with some of these like synthetics coming in and a little bit of like electronic styles also. And I mean, the beat is like really interesting with those like really nice tops on this drums there. I really enjoyed those, all of this track. But overall, I think it's a little bit too bloated on this current side and a little bit too repetitive at the end. I mean, yeah, like repeating chorus makes sense for pop music because it gets you into like this really nice rhythm in this track, and I like it for that. But still, I don't think it's the best track so far. I'm feeling something between a 6 and a 7 on this one. So let's move on with the next track, which is called Butterfly Cry, the 10th track. This kind of like shows a little bit in the songwriting wise that like the singer right here was in a little bit of like maybe of a dark place in her life, like everybody does have that sometimes. And she says like, I used to believe there was no life, I have been there, but like telling you, let's put a first client, not you, and something like that. I thought it was pretty interesting. But also that beside that, we have some nice instrumentations. This one, I like the bass, it's really nice and like really big in this track. Really nice instrumentation. Also besides that, nice groove on this one. Besides that, it's also really nice little lullabies you get in the left side. It's also some nice details in the instrumentation, and it's an enjoyable track. So let's move on. Kiss the sky. Yeah, also little nice strings on this one right here at the end, getting some other like really nice layers on this one, and it was like a little bit not building anything big, but it has some really nice instrumentation and a softness to it that really suits the songwriting on this one. And yeah, I like this track. This one was a nice one. I give this one an 8. So yeah, let's move on with the next track, the 11th track, which is called Strange Boy. Pretty straightforward track. Like the kick just starts this track off in this really nice rhythm, and really gets you into this feeling we had a couple times in this album so far, in this genre and sound, which is really interesting. And it shows some different sides, also going into some electronic sides also. And those drums are also not like real drums, they are some like analog, and not analog, digital. And it's pretty interesting going to this one right here with that kind of sound. also with some diverse instrumentation and not only easily use compressed heavy drums, which is a nice side to this album. And also the songwriting is pretty interesting, but something I like a little bit scratching my head over right now, "You Should Never Leave Me Home Alone, Heaven Knows Where Am I Gonna Wanna Go, If You Could Be My Man," and so on. But yeah, maybe something not really deeply layered in those lyrics, really, but let's move on. Yeah, really nice ending right there on the outro. It really lets like the synthetic bass already in the front right at the end, and it was really nice, like rhythmic drums also at the end. Besides the kick is a little bit too loud sometimes at the beginning, which maybe sometimes compresses out the really nice rhythm of this track. But I still think that it's kind of like a nice track and enjoyable, just like easy listen on this one right here. And I mean, the chorus just like really stuck in your head when you listen to this even once maybe. So yeah, she really has that quality of this in her kind of like the songwriting and singing, also to this album right here. And on this one, I'm feeling something between a 6 and a 7. So yeah, let's move on with the 12th track, which is called Fragile, the last track. As the last track, this kind of like makes sense to be take a little bit more time to evolve in this nice little piano we got in the back as a texture, and in the front we have some like electronics and some different like also backing vocals, which are pretty nice. Or here it's a maybe build up or main part, I don't know right now, we'll see that in when we move on. Pretty interesting like build up also, maybe, if it would be because you expect it to getting loud like at the beginning of this verse right here, or maybe chorus. So that's pretty interesting how the instrumentation stays reserved with those electronics and then the single bass just like getting linear through the track. And it's pretty interesting. Also the songwriting into like when you're at a night in a dark place or something and you feel kind of like bad, I mean, just wait, just move on, it's going to be better soon and stuff like that. Like, just you have to survive the night or something like that, if you know what I mean. It may hurt at night, like she sings right here. And yeah, let's move on. She's as cold. Yeah, this was a nice outro and the last track for this album. This was really good. The instrumentation at the end really gets some full stuff in there, and yeah, there's a build up. Maybe not like something you'd expect in the middle of this track, and you'd think like, oh well, is there no main part? But then at the end, it builds up with a nice songwriting to that, getting into a full kind of like circle of a last track. And it's as the outro is just like genius to do something like that. And then the instrumentation gets big, and then you're like, oh, the resolve, and you feel really nice. And then the like really nice instrumentation right here comes in. It's not too compressed actually on this one. I really enjoyed that last part also in the like mixing and production. So yeah, I really like that. Also the singing on this one really suits kind of like the fragileness on this track, or like the feeling that she wants to convey on this track, which was also really nice. So yeah, as the last track, that one was great. One of my favorites of the summer. I give this one a 9. So yeah, this was Love Is Dead by Curly. Really interesting album, something really different I've never done so far. And it's so often that like people request me stuff that's just like always different, and it's different again and again and again and again. And I just like think, wow, like the people who request me really have some like diverse taste, and that's really great. And I can really hear something new every time. So yeah, really diverse, sometimes a little bit emo, sometimes like really positive feeling getting across. And I mean, that's really interesting going into the songwriting aspect. And yeah, I will listen to this album a couple more times, and then I'll give you some extra thoughts. See you soon. So yeah, Love Is Dead by Curly. I listened to this album 2 more times, and one time I just like really focused on like the whole experience, the lyrics, and I went and through them again, and to see if there's something like really in between some lines I didn't really see or something like that, if you know what I mean, and really get into it. So I did that, and the other time I just was like outside, and I was just like listening to it and just getting a full listen with just the sound and experiencing it. So yeah, first things first, when I was going through like a really like deep dive again, I thought that it would be probably better to just like listen to this one as an easy listening just in the back, and to have some nice tunes in the back and some nice singing, some nice instrumentals, some really diverseness into through and through, some really nice melodies to stick in your head, and you just like think about them all day long. And then sometimes I just thought, well, yeah, this track drags on a little bit too much. The chorus is a little bit too repetitiveness, and leads to that, and just like does the same thing over and over again. While, yeah, also the instruments stay the same right there. So there's no really build up in that. Well, yes, some tracks really have that. Walking Out on Air, for example, or Fragile really have that. Butterfly Cry was also a really nice part to that, with some really diverseness all over this and no repetitiveness, which is nice. But for example, if we go into Creepshow, for example, you get what I mean. But yeah, also for that, I just really enjoyed this album, just like listening to this one once was just like, warm, just listening to it in the back, and it was nice. So I enjoyed that. While I wish there would be sometimes a little bit more something new I've never heard to this album, because I sometimes it was a little bit predictable what will come next when listening to this one. But yeah, still, I enjoyed this album. Thank you very much for requesting this. And as always, you can always request me albums with Ko-Fi if you want me to listen to your favorite albums. And so yeah, I'll see you on the next review. And on this one, Curly, Love Is Dead, I am feeling a strong 6. So yeah, see you on the next review.